All right. What's going on, everybody? How's it going, barbecue family? I think I'm finally making the move. I'm starting my own YouTube channel about barbecue, fishing, hunting, just about my life, really. And I hope that you guys will tag along this journey with me. This is Lilo. And right now I'm fixing to head to work at Hurtado BBQ. That's my new job now. I got laid off at Terry Black's. Well, we won't get too much into that, but you know, daggone coronavirus taking all of our jobs, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, just now leaving the house and gonna go work a overnight hustle shift, 4 p.m. to 4 a.m. So let's go get it. Got some banana bread. Let's do this. Hey, babe.
Yeah, a little bit better. Oh. That's fine.
Alright, so basically what I'm doing right now is I'm getting the underskirt right here, trimming this off. Just throughout the cook, it's just gonna burn. Over here, move the breastplate. Just so you know, you are on camera. So basically, remove the breastplate. Coming over here, feeling for any thin, pointy, sharp bones. I'll just poke through the foil. And then usually there are two really small bones right here. I'll go ahead and cut those off. Seems like a lot, and it is, I hate it, but. Now basically all I'm trying to do is round off everything. If the meat's real thin, it's just gonna char and burn. So, round everything off. Kind of a bit of a perfectionist, but you could literally trim off. I mean, you could spend tons of time trimming, especially on a brisket. But, you know, here's the after. Rounded off everything. Cut the breastbone. I had a little shard of bone right here, cut that off, and then removed that skirt. And that's the last one I got. So off to prepping poppers. All right, so right now, starting prep for the poppers. I have some leftover brisket. I'll go ahead and chop this up. Savage Chef, say hello.
How's it going, guys?
What you working on?
Making a little green salsa for the man, the myth, the legend, Brandon Hurtado. A little tomatillos.
Just gonna do some serranos.
Oh, yeah.
Some garlic.
Well, that's what I'm talking about.
All right, cool. Got my workstation cleaned off. Kind of fit the jalapenos, pouring them out. Taking out all the seeds. Boom. Just like that. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and stuff the jalapenos, the cream cheese brisket mixture, and get that going. This is honestly probably the longest part of prepping the jalapeno poppers is actually stuffing them. Want to stuff a good amount. You know, again, people pay good money.
All right, cool. So now I got all the jalapenos stuffed. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap them in bacon. And it's real easy. Exactly all I do is place the jalapeno here, lift up, turn to its side, and then just roll on down. Jalapeno popper. Texas Twinkie, as they call it. And then I'll just finish these up and I'll speed up the film. Blood everywhere, that'd be nice. But same thing, just a little bit of yellow mustard. If it needs a little bit more, you know, you could add a little bit at a time, but you know, if you add too much, you can't take it away.
Check that rack brisket.
Yeah, go ahead and check it.
Well, after close. Once we put that one on, I'll check it just so we're not opening the door.
Yeah, of course.
Extra time. I think it's impossible to overseason a pork butt.
Wow, there's so much meat.
And it's thick.
Yeah. It's a big piece of meat. I think you can make it too salty, but, I mean...
Even that, I mean, it's pretty hard, because it's not going to be able to penetrate until you...
Boom. The savage chef. Yeah, he's right. I mean, to a certain extent, I mean, I'm not
We're not injecting them or anything like that. We're just doing the Hurtado dry rub, pork rub, and mustard slather.
Check, it's about 1:09 in the morning right now. It's starting to rain, it's really cold. I'm already done prepping everything for tomorrow. I don't want to show you guys the pit or anything like that, you know, with the cold and rainy, and plus they're wrapped. Next time I do an overnight when the weather's great, then I'll show the pit a little bit and go from there. But I appreciate you guys bearing with me through this video. I'm gonna get everything edited, you guys. First video done basically, and more to come. So you guys have a good one, and I will see y'all later.